Hello students, today we will study about Muhammad Ghori. Towards the end of the 12th century, Ghiyasuddin Ghori formed a new kingdom in Ghor. It was in northwestern Afghanistan near Ghazni. His brother, Muizzuddin Muhammad, better known as Muhammad Ghori, decided to conquer India and take away its wealth. So we see after Mahmud of Ghazni, Muhammad Ghori of Ghor attacked India. He brought the area of Multan, Sindh and Punjab under his control. Let us now discuss about important battles of Muhammad Ghori. First battle of Taran. In 1191, Ghori attacked Prithviraj Chauhan. He was the Rajput ruler of Delhi and Ajmer. Ghori was defeated by Prithviraj in this first battle of Taran, but he returned the next year to avenge his defeat. Now let's see what happened in the second battle of Taran. Prithviraj formed an alliance of Rajput chiefs to fight Ghori, but Raja Jayachandra of Kannauj, the most powerful Rajput ruler, refused to help him. Muhammad Ghori defeated the Rajput army in the second battle of Taran in 1192. This marked the end of Rajput rule in North India. Delhi passed into the hands of Muhammad Ghori, which was ruled by Muslim rulers till 1858. 2 years later, Muhammad attacked Kannauj and killed its ruler Jayachandra. He added the Indian kingdoms to his empire and appointed Qutbuddin Aibak as his viceroy, that is his representative, before returning to Ghor. Qutbuddin captured Kalinjar in Bundelkhand, Ahinwara in Gujarat, Mathura, Gwalior, Malwa, and thus extended Ghori's empire in northern India. Muhammad bin Bakhtiar Khilji, another general of Ghori, swept across Bihar and defeated Sena dynasty of Bengal. The invaders destroyed many Buddhist monasteries and libraries. It was a death blow to Buddhism. In India, few monks escaped to Tibet with their manuscripts. Neither Muhammad Ghori was a great military leader like Mahmud of Ghazni, nor did he patronize art and learning like him. Yet he is called the founder of the Turkish kingdom in India, with Delhi as his capital. The period between 1206 to 1526 is known as the period of the Delhi Sultanate, because the rulers were called sultans and they ruled from their capital, Delhi. Five dynasties ruled during this period, starting with the Mamluk dynasty. Muhammad Ghori had no heirs, so after his death in 1206, his viceroys declared themselves independent. Qutbuddin Aibak, his viceroy in India, led the foundation of Delhi Sultanate in India. This dynasty is also known as the Mamluk dynasty. He ruled for 4 years. He was a just and generous ruler. He looked after the welfare of his subjects. He was known as Luck Baksh or Giver of Lakhs because of his generosity. He treated the Hindus well, yet he broke many temples to collect wealth and materials in order to build mosques and other monuments. He built two mosques, one in Delhi and another one in Ajmer. He started building the Qutub Minar, but he was completed by Iltutmish because of his accidental death. The fifth and last story of the Minar was added by Firoz Shah Tughlaq. It is one of the most famous monuments in India and was used as a minaret by the muezzins to summon Muslims for prayers. Now Iltutmish. Qutbuddin fell from a horse and died in 1210. His son succeeded him but was replaced by his son-in-law Iltutmish. He was a capable ruler. First, he consolidated, that is, unified his possessions and stabilized, that is, secured his position by treating all his oppositions in a shrewd and clever manner. Now, let us see how he accomplished this. The Turkish nobles were suppressed. The revolt of the Khilji governor of Bengal was crushed. The ruler of Ghazni and Multan was destroyed. The Mongol chief Chinggis Khan reached border of India chasing the Shah of Persia. The Shah had requested Iltutmish for shelter, but he refused him and saved India from Mongol invasion. Later, Iltutmish defeated the Rajput rulers of Ujjain, Ranthambore, Malwa and Gwalior. Thus, he brought the whole of North India up to River Narmada under his control. Even the caliphs of Baghdad honored him as the sovereign or supreme of India. Now, let us discuss about administration. Iltutmish was a good organizer and introduced many changes. He organized the finance and the revenue department. The empire was divided into many provinces called Iktas, which was managed by Iktadars, who collected land revenue and maintained law and order. He was the first to mint gold and silver coins. He completed the Qutub Minar and built his own red sandstone tomb in Delhi. He was a patron of art and learning. He gave refuge to many scholars driven in exile from various parts of Asia. Now, so we see he was the true founder of Turkish rule in India and changed the loosely knit, that is, distant territories in India into a strong, well-defined, compact state. Now, this is your worksheet. You have to write the answers in any notebook or copy you have at home. You can use the comment section of the video for any query or question. Thank you.